The views and opinions expressed do not necessarily represent those of Access Fort Wayne, the Allen County Public Library, or any other supporting group. Get involved with Access Fort Wayne and make your own television programming. Call 421-1250 to find out more.
Thank you. One Piece here.
Okay.
We're both filming our shows at the same time, so that's cool. Don't mind us. We just happened to meet up with Jerry here and Wesley. Yeah. So I'm competing to win.
Tell
first.
Us what you have there.
This is our Rayquaza. It's light up. It does the confetti. It wraps around my body. So that's
Did you bring your car today?
No, just myself. I took a ride here.
Okay.
So.
Are you? Is there any costume judging going on?
There will be at 3:30 at the plaza is where we'll be.
That's okay. Where we set to hit it.
So we got at least Wesley to film most of it, because I'm going to be in it trying to compete and film what I can from where I'm at.
Will do. Okay.
But yeah. That's all this. Right. Well, it's a nice surprise. All surprises are right here on Heart of Japan and Wesley's TV and all that. So
let's have Mario here give us a give us a talk.
Yep. We are the Super Mario Brothers.
Yeah.
cosplay. This is my first cosplay this year.
Is it really? Well, I'm so glad to have you. Good, good. And who's this character here?
My name is Monkey D. Luffy, soon to be King of the Pirates.
King of the Pirates.
Whoa, you look like a pirate.
That's what it looks like, too. Good job, guys.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Tell us about your character.
His name is Kankri Vantis. He's a troll, an alien.
An alien troll, yes. Okay, with fangs.
Yes. He actually has a full mouth of sharp teeth, but
wow.
Yeah, I don't have any for that.
Well, looks pretty good. Looks pretty scary. And who do you have with you here?
I'm just wearing traditional garb that I made at home.
You made that?
Well,
that's quite talented. I couldn't be doing that. So good job. And who do you have with you?
I'm a frog.
Okay. Tell us about what you do. Do you have any special powers?
I'm the universe frog. I am a universe.
I guess I'm not familiar with that. Can you explain?
Yeah, these go together.
Oh, they both go together.
Yeah.
Very good, very good. Okay. I actually have some powers of my own. I'm actually a magician. Okay. Do you like magic?
Yeah.
You do, okay. Let's use your imagination. You look like you have a good one, okay? Just pretend like we have an invisible deck of cards. Go ahead and take those. Okay, now take them out of the deck, take them out of the box, look at the cards, and pick any card that you want in your mind.
Okay.
Okay? Now they don't know, and I don't know what you pick, okay? But what we want you to do is the card that you pick, all the cards are face up, turn that one upside down. Slide it, now put them back in the box. Okay, now take the box. So you know your card, right?
Yep.
Okay, I'm going to look in your eyes, try to figure out what your card is. I'm actually going to turn around, and I'm going to turn one card upside down of all these cards, okay? Okay, now, for the first time, tell us all what your card was.
I was thinking Four of Diamonds.
Four of Diamonds, okay. Four of Diamonds. One card.
That is amazing.
That's awesome.
That's cool. Of all those cards.
Yeah. Nice. Very good.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. For this, God adore this.
Yeah. She's a little, she's the one that's ever.
Got some very important news to tell you about, but first I'm going to show you that something can come out of nothing. I got blue, red, and white. I'm going to put that back in my hand. You know what that reminds me of? Red, white, and blue? Reminds me of the American flag. Isn't that something? Look at that. There it is. There. Now, American flag, like we always kind of know, fun time, like 4th of July, things like that. But we got a special event coming up. It's from Wesley's TV. It's called Fun and Sun at the Park. Okay, and so please join all of us and all Wesley's crew and Wesley on Thursday, June 28th this year from 11 a.m. to 8 p.m. at Lakeside Park Pavilion. And it'll be number 2 Pavilion. For a fun summer day with Wesley TV. We will have entertainment such as food and snacks and activities for all ages and a lot more. Please stay tuned for more information coming soon, and please follow us on Facebook at Wesley TV, which would be, or Wesley's TV Community Outreach Events for more details. And remember, this is going to be at Lakeside Park, Pavilion number 2, and the address is 1401 Lake Avenue in Fort Wayne. And when? It's going to be Tuesday, June 28, 2022, from 11 a.m. to 8 p.m. So we'll look for you then.
Yes. Okay. Get a hold of that, give it a pull, since we know it's a real rope, it doesn't come apart, and take it, put it around my neck here, then I'm going to tie it in the front, okay, I'm going to pull the net, this knot all the way through my neck. There you go. Now, I'm going to show you some magic, okay, first. Pick a ring. This one? Okay. Hold the ring. Put the ring on this, on the rope.
Put it on?
Yep. Try to put it about right in the middle. Okay, there you go. Very good. There's the ring right there. Okay. And then I'm actually going to wrap the rope up here like so. Okay, there. Now, untie the rope.
Untie it?
Mm-hmm. There you go.
Wait.
It's behind your ear.
What? What? I'm so confused.
I'm going to teach you this trick. Okay? And here's how it works, okay? It's called sleight of hand magic, okay? It's about right in the middle. And when I'm holding it like this, I'm going to say I'm going to wrap the rope up. And then I take my hand up here, drop the ring into my hand here, okay? Then I wrap it up like this, and now it rings in my hand. Isn't that something? Yeah. Then when you unwrap it, gone. and then you can make it appear anywhere you want. Nine but how do you practice doing it, okay? Because if you practice, then you'll be able to do it. Like that, okay? Now, when you're getting ready to wrap the rope, you take it like this. Now you take your hand real close and drop it into the other hand. And now start wrapping the rope in that hand. See that? Then you just put this down to your side and have somebody unwrap the rope. And it's gone. And then you can make it appear behind the
like ear. That. Yeah.
I'm gonna use this trick. I'm gonna use this trick.
I'm gonna use it for my mom.
I'm gonna do that.
Isn't that clever? It's just a matter of being clever with your hands. You know? So that's a lot of what trick, it's a lot of what magic is being clever. Good, I'm glad you remembered me. I'm going to be at Busker Fest, and I'll show you some more magic out there.
Alright.
So, good.
Okay, get out there.
Maybe you can practice this and show me when you can do it.
I will.
Okay. The wrapping around your neck is a little harder to do. That one takes a little more practice, pulling it through your neck. I seen Chris Angel take a chain and wrap a chain around his neck and pull it through. So I can't do the chain, but I can do the rope. So. Okay. Good talking to y'all. Did you get her on film?
Yeah. Can you tell us who you are?
Yeah. I'm Vocaloid from Ren in her spring attire.
That's cute.
I'll be in the contest also.
Good. And what's your real name?
My name's Alana Mercer.
Alana? Good. Good.
Say one more time, Alana what?
Alana Mercer.
Okay.
And is this your first year?
No, this is my several years, but okay. This is my first time doing my cosplay contest.
We really wish you good luck on your contest.
My first time, I took home first place. This is my third time.
I did see you first place.
Yeah.
First time. I took a picture with you, actually. I have a picture.
Okay.
Which one do you like better, the large one or the wraparound one?
The large one was way much cooler, and everyone was amazed by it.
Okay. So I don't think
the wraparound, I don't know, but they might be surprised. But then again, there's always new competition.
Yeah, there is. So I want to do
same extraordinary attendance for the costume competition this year. As a matter of fact, I had to limit the number of entrants, which I don't normally have to do. But anyways, we'll start getting our entrants down here and set up and ready to go. I want to thank all of them for doing this, and they are obviously having a blast doing it. I want to thank all of you for coming out here and giving them such a nice audience. And I want to thank my assistants here, because this is a whole lot of work for one person. So, Jessica? Sorry, technical details. We're wrangling cats. Trying to. Is Paul Brown is Joker from Persona 5. Now entering the leader of the Phantom Thieves, Joker.
Greetings, everyone. My name is Joker. I'm the leader of the Phantom Thieves, and I'm gonna steal all your guys' hearts.
But Joker, we have to find the treasure.
Right. Does anyone know where the treasure's at? No one? Anyone? Because Kamoshida's here, and he's ready to steal his heart. But I will be here, and I will steal his assorted sires and take him down! Persona! Thank you so much. I appreciate every one of you guys.
That was Paul Brown as Joker from Persona 5. Next up is Skylar as Luffy from One Piece. Introducing Monkey D. Luffy, the man who will be the Pirate King.
Oh, no. My name is Monkey D. Luffy, soon to be King of the Pirates. If you sacrifice your friends for your, if you sacrifice your friend for a dream and treasure, it won't be worth anything. There's no point anymore. I won't lose because I have all my friends with me. My dream, my crew, and the treasure. I will have them all. I'm gonna be King of the Pirates. Do you hear me? Thank you all so much. Sanji, I'm hungry. I need food.
Oh, yeah, I know, but...
Skylar is Monkey D. Luffy from One Piece. Next up, we have Brandon Loesch and Son as Goku and Gohan from Dragon Ball Z. So was the spike bat. The memories will live on forever. Memento mori. Let's see. Next is Marianne Paulus as Sonya Nevermind from Danganronpa 2. Sonya Nevermind is a high school princess. She likes to make friends even though she is royalty. She likes to do art, read, and help her people. She's trained in martial arts in secret so that she can help her people be safe. She helps with volunteering to help others. Marianne Paulus is Sonya Nevermind from Danganronpa 2. Entry number 10, Chaotic Nova, okay. Tetsu Kabaragi from Tiger and Bunny. All about justice and protecting the city of Sternbild, he has partnered with another hero to stay relevant as a hero. Though juggling his private life and his hero life, he never gives up. Next we have Isabel Van Gorder as Chiaki Nanami from Danganronpa 2, Goodbye Despair. Chiaki Nanami from Danganronpa 2, the ultimate gamer. Video games are her hobby and she loves all genres.
Yeah, me too.
Okay. Number 13 is Nadi Wu with Sakura Kinimoto. Sakura. This girl is cute but mighty. She fights many things that come upon her. Nadi Wu, Sakura Kinimoto. Number 14, Taylor Royce as Brenda with Rayquaza. Pokemon series, Pokemon Emerald. Pokemon trainer Brendan with a wraparound holographic confetti blasting light up Rayquaza made from 100% recycled material, including the glitter.
I want to give an extra special shout out to the second place contestant from 2018 competition. This was made just for you. Thanks for inspiring me so much.
Just a bit of a background, there were two entries at that year that were, I could not tell between the two of them. They were both that good, and then all of a sudden he comes out and spews glitter everywhere, and we're like, oh hell. All right. We have Reynard Captor and Spinneret as Solux Captor and Vriska Circuit from Homestuck. Solus and Vriska are usually drawn in modern Western clothing, but these traditionally styled Japanese outfits, including the characters' distinctive details. The respective symbols are embroidered as if they were Japanese clan symbols, and the fabrics include the characters' distinctive yellow and blue colors and their themes. Bees for him and spider webs for her. Vriska even has her signature red shoes. Reynard Captor and Spinneret with Solic Captor and Vriska Circuit from Homestuck. Number 16, Kiri Copper as Rurichiru Shurikien from Inuex Baku SS. Copper cosplay and presenting with Chirichiro for their first ever cosplay competition. Number 18, Zhao Venti, Huatao, and Chongyun from Genshin Impact. Adeptus Zhao Barbatos and the director of the Wansheng Funeral Parlor. Zhao Venti, Huatao, and Chongyun from the Genshin Impact. Entry number 18. Okay. All right. Citrus Sal is Onome and McKeon Sumiki from Super Dragon Ranpa 2. Entry number 19, Lost Chrome, Elias Trancy from Black Butler. This cosplay was handmade using recycled materials such as curtains, bed sheets, and old clothing, and was found around her house. Entry Entry number 20, Sprinkles and River, as Yoaj Melu and Randy Kovaca from Bluey Capsules. Sprinkles is doing Yoaj vacation outfit, and River is doing Chica's Party World uniform. Entry number 21, Julia and Michelle as Todovoki and Ururaka from Baku no Hero Academia. What do we have? Okay. I'm sorry. There are a few people who actually decided that the heat was too much. Unfortunately, it is a thing that we have to deal with. Okay. Alice Aldry and Jocelyn Tigner as Taniyara Kameda and Nezuko Kamudo from Demon Slayer. Hello, my name is Nezuko. I'm a demon. I'm Dejiro, a soldier brother that protects my baby sister, Nezuko, that is a demon. I will turn her back to human no matter what. Alright. Spencer Mitchell Swizen Swarden as Super Mario from Super Mario.
It's-a me, Mario!
Angel Wilt as Seraphie, the sacrificial princess and the king of beasts. Cosplay was homemade by Angel, and with the help of her mother, this cosplay also includes plushie versions of two Seraphie's friends, Huey and Plops.
Hello, it's nice to meet you all. Obviously, I came back from the Beast Kingdom temporarily, so then hopefully I can have you meet all of my friends later on. I hope to see you all again soon. Bye-bye.
Next we have Yasuo Kato as from One Piece.
Yes, I can!
Next we have Aaron Felton as James from Pokemon. Okay folks, we know it. Prepare for trouble and... James from Team Rocket. I'll say, has anybody seen a loudmouth redhead around? Or maybe that pesky Pikachu. Hey, wait a minute. I think I see something yellow out over there.
I'm coming for you.
James from Pokemon. Next we have Gabrielle Christie as Hitoshi Sinsun from My Hero Academia.
So I guess that perverted grape did something creepy to the girls again. Oh well, I'm gonna take his place anyway. Hey Mr. Aizawa, I'm gonna be your favorite purple one this time.
Jensen is going to replace Emeta as the superior purple character. Next we have Angel from Violet Evergarden. Violet is a past veteran. She never really had emotions, but she holds on to the emotion. She spends her days as an Archmage's doll, searches for her Magister. She lost in the last war. Next we have Danny Morin as Runa Yomozuki from Kagakuri. Runa is one of the student council of gambling schools. She loves games, suckers, and being the referee of games. Next we have Layla Patalitu as Hatsume Miku from Vocaloid. Next we have Tiffany and Elizabeth as Monokuma and Monomi from Danganronpa.
Chills, kills! You hateful bear, you deserve a thousand deaths!
Somebody who came out and had the personality, had the costume, had the shtick, that's what we all look for. Paul Brown is Joker from Persona 5. Take this, which is third place, which is $20. $20. And we have a certificate that he can show off.
Thank you so much, everyone. Over there, he's over there flipping. But my wife was here.
Okay. In second place, Taylor Royce is Brendan with Rayquaza. Woo!
Awesome, man. Thank you. Congratulations, buddy. You were amazing. Thank you.
And in first place, Renard Captor and Spinneret with Solix Captor and Vriska Circuit from Homestuck. Let's give these all folks a big round of applause because this is just the amount of work necessary for all this to happen. Thank you all, folks. Take a bow.
Thank you, everyone.
At this time, I also want to invite all of the people who helped me behind the scenes this afternoon, without which I would be utterly dead up here and you would not even be seeing me. So I want to honor this group who do this for fun and also for charity.
Sorry.
Would the members of the Summit City Cosplayers come on up here? Come on, come on. I don't care if you're not in costume. Without their help, I would not be able to pull this off. You're entirely way too much. But then again, you're a Saiyan, so what can we say?
Half Saiyan.
He's insane. He's kind of like infamous.
It has been such an honor to help out with this amazing event today. We are the Summit City Cosplayers. We do charity work, we do walks. We help fundraise for various events. And it's just our heart's passion to help out with our community, to make all of you smile, and to bring all of us together.
So a round of applause for my assistants this year. And some point or another, the judges for the art contest should be down here. Just stick around for that.
Sometimes you stand, sometimes you turn your back to the wind. There's a world outside every darkened door, where blues won't haunt you anymore. Where the brave are free and lovers soar. Come ride with me to the distant shore. We won't hesitate to break down the garden gate. There's not much time left today.